Example 4, 24 mL of water gas containing only hydrogen and carbon monoxide is in equal proportions by volume. So CO and H2, this is, are in 1:1 ratio, equal proportions, taken 24 mL. So this will also split into 1:1 ratio, 12 mL, 12 mL, are exploded with 80 mL of air. So the air is taken 80 mL. Of this 80 mL, only 20% is oxygen. 20% is oxygen is 20 by 100 into 80, which will be equals to 16 mL. 16 mL is oxygen. Now, if all the gaseous volumes are measured at room temperature and pressure, calculate the composition by volume of resulting gaseous mixture. Okay, we have to find the resultant composition. Let us say CO and H2. CO and H2, they are in 1:1 ratio. So 12 mL is carbon monoxide, 12 mL is hydrogen, which are divided equally, the 24 mL. Now this reacts with oxygen. Even this will react with oxygen, gives you corresponding carbon dioxide gas in the first case and H2O. Whether to take this as gas or liquid is decided by the temperature set. The reactions are taken at room temperature. Now it is cool to room temperature. Here, let us balance this equation first. After deciding the water is liquid because of the room temperature, now the second step we have to follow is balance. We need one carbon is there. We are getting only two oxygens here. So to balance this equation, if I take half O2, the reaction gets balanced. We know CO is a gas, oxygen is a gas, and carbon dioxide is a gas. H2 is a gas, O2 is a gas, but H2 is a liquid. Now apply Gay-Lussac's law of relationship. Whatever is the volume ratio they combine, that will be deciding the reaction at which they react with each other. Now if I am taking the mole ratio, 1 mole of carbon monoxide will always react with half mole of oxygen. So 1 mole will always react with half mole of oxygen to give 1 mole of carbon dioxide. So if I say what ratio the moles they react, the same ratio their volumes will react. For 1 mole, half mole oxygen is required. So for 1 ml, half ml oxygen is required. For 12 ml, half of 12 ml, 6 ml is required. So if 12 ml reacts with 6 ml, how much carbon dioxide will be formed? Now you see the reaction, 1 mole will give you 1 mole. That means 1 ml will give you 1 ml. 12 ml will give you 12 ml. So the amount, the volume of carbon dioxide formed will be 12 ml. Same way, if I am taking hydrogen in this case, hydrogen also comes in the same type of conclusion. Let me take the hydrogen. 1 mole of hydrogen reacts with half mole. So it also reacts with half mole of oxygen to give 1 mole of H2O. Since H2O is a liquid, we don't even consider how much water is going to form. But let us see, if 1 mole reacts with half mole, 1 ml reacts with half ml, 12 ml will react with 6 ml of oxygen. So the volume of oxygen that will be reacted is also known to us, 6 ml. Now let us understand, CO is completely consumed in the reaction. Now there is no more CO in the reaction. Hydrogen is completely consumed in the reaction. There is no more hydrogen in the reaction. Now the total oxygen we have is 16 ml. Of this 16 ml, it is only 6 ml plus 6 ml is consumed, which is equals to 16 minus 12, 4 ml is left. 4 ml of oxygen is left. And how much carbon dioxide is formed? Carbon dioxide is formed, which is 12 ml. And the nitrogen is left in the mixture. Nitrogen. Of the total, if you have seen in the previous case, see here we have taken 80 ml of air. Air is a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen. Of 80 ml, 16 ml is oxygen. So the remaining 64 ml remains which one? Nitrogen. So 64 ml remains in the nitrogen. So the composition of gases which are left is oxygen with 4 ml, carbon dioxide with 12 ml, and nitrogen with 64 ml will be your composition that will be left in the reaction. So the answer 12 ml, this is going to be only carbon dioxide, but remaining also has to be mentioned. 4 ml oxygen, 64 ml nitrogen.